Hello, everyone. Welcome. Thank you for joining me for this live English class from BBC Learning English. Today's topic, you may have seen the promo video earlier. But today's topic is make and do. We're looking at these two verbs, which are often confused. Before we started, some of you may have seen a promo video on Facebook, and I asked you these questions. Okay, these questions. I wanted you to answer them with a form of make or do. To see if you knew the answers, okay? And I'll be giving you the answers again in a minute. A couple of things before we start, I just wanted to remind you of. This lesson is live, so do please join in. Please say where you're watching from. Add in the comments where you're watching from. It's great to see. We've got some already, a few people saying hi already. I'll say hello to a few of you. So hello to Ksenia from Russia. Hello from Damoui from Algeria. I'm going to say hi to Cedric from Ivory Coast. Hi to all of you that are watching. And I will put up some comments as you go through. The other thing to remember, this lesson will be posted on our Facebook and YouTube channels as soon as we've finished. So do please, if you need to watch it again, you can see it all there. Remember, as it's live, you can invite anyone to join in, invite your friends. If you're watching in the replay, don't worry, you can still share this video with anyone, and do make sure that you're following and you're subscribed to us. Another thing to mention, you should see a comment somewhere from BBC Learning English with a link to a worksheet, okay? A worksheet like this, which will help you practice what we've looked at today. Okay, enough about that. Let's get started. So let's start by looking at the answers to these questions. Okay, the answers to these questions. I saw a lot of the answers that people have put earlier, and I think everyone got them right. Said, have you done your homework? And I'm going to make a card for her. Now, what I want you to think about, and we're going to look at now, is what the reasons that it's this. Why is it done? And why is it make? Why do you think? Okay, you can pop it into the comments. We're going to be asking lots of questions as we go through. So as you see the questions, please put the answers in there. Okay, let's go through. So we've got two things here. We've got someone doing their homework, and we've got some, well, I think it's breakfast. Let's call it avocado toast. Probably breakfast or brunch or something like that, a meal. Now, as a general pattern, it's not always true, and there are many, many exceptions, which is why this is so difficult. But as a general pattern, when we use make, so for example, make breakfast or make avocado toast, often we have a product. We have something, a thing at the end. And when we use do, so for example, for your homework, you do your homework, you do some study, it's an activity. Okay, so that's a big difference where we often use them. They're not the only times we use them, and there are lots of exceptions, and we're going to have a look at some of the exceptions at the end. So do keep watching until the end of the lesson. It's really important, because we're going to have a look at some of the exceptions then. But this is a pattern that can help you. Okay. Right. So if you have just joined us, this is a live English class from BBC Learning English. And we're looking at make and do and how to know when to use each of them. So let's look a bit more in depth at this. Okay, so make, for example, here's our first example. We often use make in cooking. Talk about making dinner, making breakfast, making cake, making bread, making lasagna. I don't know, whatever you like to make. Do, if you want to share what you like to make, please put it in the comments and share it with all of us. We can also use make for sort of craft-related things, for using your skills. If you can make something, if you can build something or create something with your skills, then you make it, kind of craft-based thing. And kind of related to that, we often use it to talk about creative things that you produce. You make them, okay? So here's some examples. So we could look at food. I made a cake, or maybe like Olena, you can make borscht, or like Rahat, you can make biryani, okay? All kinds of things we can make. We use it a lot with food. I made a cake. I made borscht. I made biryani. Whatever you particularly like to eat. Okay. We use it there. We talk about craft. So here in this example, my sister made this table. Okay, maybe you're very good at carpentry. You can make things out of wood. You create something. You're using your skill. Okay. People are still talking about food. Lukita saying that they can make pizza. Yes. Food sticks in your mind, doesn't it? Okay. And then the other one here, we talk about creative things. One example, we want to make a video, or you make a film, or maybe you're a sculptor, you make a statue. Okay, so for a lot of creative things, we would use make. Okay, some others, we have other verbs. So for a story, you write a story, or a picture, you draw or paint a picture. Okay, let's go on. Let's have a look at do. So we have a little look at do. One of the things we often use do for is work. Often activities, and we said it was often with activities, we can use do with things, activities you have to perform at work. It's very common there. Also, chores or housework. If you don't know that word, jobs around your house, we'll often say do for them. Okay, we'll often say do. And then often when we're not specifying what we're doing, when we're talking in general, we often use do. Now let's have a look at some examples here. So for something at work, I'm doing some filing. It's kind of a boring task that you do lots and lots of times, and we use do with it. Obviously it depends on your job. If you're a carpenter, then probably you make lots of things when you're working. So we can use make, or if you're a chef, then you'll be making food. But we often use do for a lot of the activities that are involved in our jobs. So we use do quite a lot. Are there any things in your job that you have to do that you don't really like? Are there any things you do that you find boring? Do share them in the comments, okay? Val's actually said, I hate doing household chores. Well, here's an example of a household chore. Let's do the washing up, okay? So very similar to things in your job. Lots of the jobs around the house, we use do with them. Do the washing up. Okay, do the washing up. Here's another example, actually, that's really good for some sporting activities. Natalia has said, I do karate. Okay, yeah, we can often use it for kind of sporting activities as well. Okay, so, excellent. Okay, oh yes, right, saying do your homework, as we said earlier. Yes, you do your homework. It's another kind of job. Okay, now this one, we talk about unspecified activities. When we're talking in general, it's a bit harder to define. We've got, I did nothing yesterday. I did nothing yesterday. Do you want to do something today? When we're talking in general, we can use do for activities. Okay, that's quite a lot of information. Don't worry, we will post this lesson up on our YouTube and Facebook channels afterwards so you can watch it again. But in the meantime, let's have some questions. I want to hand it over to you. So I've got some questions for you here, all using make and do. So let's look at the first one. We're talking about bread, okay? Bread, what do we use here? Is it going to be make or do? What do you think? Put it into the comments. If you have just joined us, this is a live lesson from BBC Learning English with me, Phil. Do please join in, come in the comments, say where you're watching from, and also answer the questions that we're asking. Do please join in. Remember, you can invite your friends to join in the lesson, invite as many people as you can. You can also share this lesson. We are posting the whole thing up on our Facebook and YouTube channels afterwards. You can always watch it again. If you are watching on the replay, hi guys, thank you for joining in. You can join in the comments as well. Don't let that stop you. And of course, there is a worksheet that you can download from the link that will be in the comments for more practice. But let's get back to bread. What do we think? I'm seeing lots of answers here. Bill is saying make. RSD saying make or bake. Yes, you could use bake as well. Diane saying make. I apologize if I pronounce your name wrong. Make. I've got some others. Diana saying make. Yeah, everyone's saying make. And everyone's saying make because it's the right answer. Okay. We use it a lot with cooking. We use it a lot with food. We said that. And there's a product at the end of it. You have a loaf of bread in your hand. So make bread, make a cake, and the other examples that we had earlier that you suggested, which were great. Okay, let's look at the second question. Around the house, I need to some gardening. Okay, maybe the grass is very long, the flowers are all out of control. Yeah, gardening. What verb am I going to use here? Is it make or do? Okay, work in the garden. What's the verb we're going to use here? What do you think? Please put it into the comments. Am I going to make or do gardening? What do you think? Nick says do. Octam says do. Chappie says quit. Okay, maybe if you don't want to do it. Sarah saying do. Yeah, lots of answers coming in. I need to do, says Bice. Okay. Rosario, I need to do. Yeah, you're all getting the right answers. It is I need to do some gardening. I need to do some gardening. It's like a household chore, like activity or a job. We use do with these quite often. Okay, do remember there are exceptions to most of these, but these are general pattern. This is a general pattern that will help you. Okay, but you will see and hear exceptions. And we'll look at some of those at the end of the lesson. Do not miss the end of the lesson because we're going to go more into those exceptions, the really tricky ones then. So do make sure you keep watching. Okay. What about this one? Hopefully not true about today, but maybe. I'm tired. I don't want to anything. What do you think goes in that gap? If you have just joined us, this is a live lesson from BBC Learning English. We're looking at the difference between make and do when we use these verbs. And I'm asking some questions, so do please join in the comments and put what you think the answer is here. It's a clue. It's either going to be make or do, but which one is it? What do you think? Okay, I'm going to dive into the comments and have a look and see what some of you have been putting. Lots of people agree. Margarita saying do. Green saying do. Khan saying do. Espe, do anything. Yes, we've got a few others here. Rahat saying do as well. Yeah, great. We're talking in general here. We're talking very much in general. Kind of general unspecified activities we often use do. I'm tired. I don't want to do anything. Okay. Hopefully that's not true because you're in a live lesson and there's lots of questions to answer. Okay. I wish this was true for me, but I don't think I've got the skill. What would we put here? We can use make or we can use do, but which one is the correct one? What do you think? A toy for my children. I've a toy for my children. So it's present perfect. But which past participle is going in there? To be made or done? What do you think? Please put your answers in the comments as we look at make and do in this live English class with BBC Learning English. While you're looking, I'm just going to remind you that we will be posting the whole lesson afterwards onto our Facebook and YouTube channel. So if you miss anything, you can always watch again. Please also invite anyone you know who might want to watch. Please invite them to join in. Okay, let's go through. Let's have a look and see what we've got. We've got made, says Eoki. Massimo says made. Sophie says buy. Well, actually, I buy most of the toys for the kids, but yes. Made from Sarah also saying made. Bill saying make. Okay, fantastic. And the answer is I've made a toy for my children. I've made a toy for my children. Okay, excellent. Yes, it's a product. You've used your skill. You've created something. We use make here, usually. Again, do watch out for the exceptions. We've got exceptions coming up and we'll talk about those. Okay, let's make it a little bit more difficult. Let's have a question with two answers. Okay, so put your first answer and then your second answer. It's probably the easy way to answer this one. I something some cleaning and then the lunch yesterday. And then lunch yesterday. Is it make and make? Is it do and do? Is it, which ones are they? Or are they different? Is it make and do? Is it do and make? It's probably going to be past tense because it was yesterday. So it's probably going to be made and done. But where do they go? Or made and made? Or done and done? What do you think? Okay, if you haven't just joined us, it's a live lesson on make and do from BBC Learning English. My name's Phil. I'm here in my house. Oh, and I can see some answers coming in already. Do keep them coming in. It's great as you join in. Larissa has said did and made. Yeah, Tiara saying the verbs we need are do and make. Fatima is saying did and made. Nick said done and made. Okay, everyone is saying the same thing. And again, everyone's got it right. I did some cleaning and then I made lunch yesterday. Okay, both kind of household chores, both of them really, but one is more of an activity and one we're focusing more on the product. Okay, and we said with food, we usually use make with food. Informally, you will sometimes hear people using do, but it's quite informal. Okay, sometimes it might be inappropriate. Make with food is never inappropriate. Okay, let's have a look. We've got another question here. I something a model. What goes in the gaps? Put your answers into the comments. What do you think? Let's have a look. What do you think? So work on my art project. What verb are we going to use for that one? And something, a model. And again, this is going to be past simple. What do you think it's going to be? What do you think the answers are? Okay, let's have a look through. Yunpan is saying, do some work, make a model. Kim is saying it's make and then do. Who else we got? Raneem saying did and made. Ksenia is saying made and made. Cedric saying do and made. Nick saying did and did. Okay, we've got quite a few different answers here. So let's have a look at the answer. Let's see what it should be. Okay. I did some work on my art project. I made a model. I did some work on my art project. I made a model. Okay, we talked about work and activities. Did some work. We use do with work. But a model is something that you create using your skill and you have a product at the end of it. You have the model at the end of it. So I did some work on my art project. I made a model. Okay. I've been asking you lots of questions here and you've been coming up with some very good answers. Almost most of the answers have been correct, which is great. I want to hand it over to you now. Why don't you tell me in the comments, what things can you make and what things do you want to do? So if I was going to talk about myself, I'm not very practical. I can cook, so I can make bread, I can make lasagna, I can make pizza. But for other things, I'm not very practical. I can't make furniture. I can't make toys for my children. I can't do those things. What things can you make? And then what things do you want to do? I'm thinking maybe I need to do some exercise myself. Someone suggested doing karate earlier. That sounds fun, but I don't know how to do it. What do you think? Bill wants to make a table. Fantastic. If you're a good carpenter, then you could do that. Anetta wants to make breakfast. Green can make capsa. Luis can make an omelette. Lynn also can make a good meal. Anaga, again, apologies if I pronounce your name wrong, can do workouts. Coneheads wants to make dinner, can make dinner. Okay, lots of different things there. What, anything that people want to do anymore? Najat will make sweetbread later and then do some research for their project. Okay, that's a really nice one. I can make dinner for family and do homework for my son. Very good. Maybe you need to get your son to do the homework. But yes, fantastic. Brilliant. Mr. True saying, I can make mobile apps. I want to do work on Google. Kim says, I don't want to do anything. Lots of good comments coming in here. Sarah says, I'm not that bad at cooking, so I think I'll be the one who makes dinner for today. Excellent. But, oh, getting the wrong comments. Natalia saying, I can do tests in foreign languages. Can you do well in tests? Excellent. If Yevgeny likes to do English exercises. Brilliant. Olena can make Turkish breakfast and you want to do it together with your friend. Brilliant. Okay, and then we're actually talking about the activity afterwards. We're using do then, and because we're talking about it as an activity. Okay, brilliant. Fantastic examples there. Great examples. Well done, everyone. Okay, I did say we were going to look at some exceptions and some things where it doesn't necessarily follow the rule, and some set expressions where we use one or we use the other. And I want to see if you know these ones. Some of them probably you do know. Some might be a little bit new. So for this one, a call, do we use make or do with a call? What do you think? If you have just joined us, this is a live English class from BBC Learning English, and we're looking at make and do. Make and do, and when we use them. What do you think we use with a call? Okay, Yunpan has said to make a call. Okay, to make a call. Okay, I actually see lots of other people have also said make. Gusty is saying make. Superman, it's good that Superman's watching. Superman said to make a call. Stacy has said to make a call. Yeah, the answer is make a call. We make a telephone call. If you've got your phone, you make a call. Okay, brilliant. Right, what about these expressions? Your best, good, and harm. Your best, good, or harm. What do we use with these? What do we put into that blank? Is it do or is it make? What do you think? I'll have a look in the comments. Do join in the comments, please. Mary's saying, you do your best. Yes, do your best is really good. Jinan has also said the same thing, to do your best. You can say that they do. These ones are all do. Wayan has also seen that you do your best. Okay, yes, you do your best. Okay, you could also say that you do good. You do something good for someone. You do good. Hopefully you don't, but or you could do harm. There are some things that do harm. So we use do with your best, do with good, and do with harm. Okay, let's have a look at the next one. Have a look at the next one. We have got an effort. What do we do with an effort? When you're really working hard, what do? Is it make or is it do? What do you think? If you have just joined us, this is a live lesson from BBC Learning English. Do look out in the comments for the comment saying where you can download our worksheet from. Okay, the worksheet will give you extra practice afterwards. That's fantastic. But with this, an effort, is it make an effort or do an effort? What do you think? Make an effort or do an effort? I can see someone's just delivering a package to me now. Hopefully someone can answer the door. Is it make an effort or do an effort? Extraordinary saying to make an effort. Yes. Pedro, make an effort. Denise, make an effort. Sarah saying make. Okay. Oh, great sentence here from Simon. I make an effort to finish my paper. Olena is making efforts to find a job. Really nice answer. Lots of the rest of you said it. I see Cedric has said it. I see Kim has said it. Yes. Make an effort. Really important. Okay. Let's have a look at the next one. A favor. Okay, if you help someone, what do we use with a favor? What do we use? Is it make or is it do? What do you think goes with a favor? What would we do here? A favor. What do you think? If you have missed anything from this lesson so far, we will be posting the whole lesson up on our social media channels on Facebook and YouTube, so you can watch it again and watch over any bits that you've missed. We're looking at make and do, and we're looking at some of the exceptions, some of the ones that don't really follow a rule, the set expressions. For a favor, what do we use with it? Do we use make or do we use do? Okay, so I can't read your name, but it's a brilliant example. Can you do me a favor? I have a problem. Daisy's saying, do me a favor. Liz is saying, to do a favor. Okay, Eva is saying, do me a favor. Okay, or to do a favor. Okay. Do a favor works on its own or in a sentence. It could be do me a favor. You can do someone else a favor. You can do lots of people a favor. Please, can you do a favor for me? Renit is saying yes. So the answer for favor is we do a favor. Okay, you make an effort, but you do a favor. Okay, let's have a look at the next one. We had do a favor. What about a suggestion? If you have an idea, what verb do we use with suggestion? What do you think it is? What do you think goes here with suggestion? What do you reckon? Seeing some more examples from earlier. Lukita is saying to make a suggestion. Do you agree? Vin is also saying to make a suggestion. Noemi is saying to make. Nubiake is saying to make a suggestion. And what do you think it is? Everyone's saying make a suggestion. Yes, you've got it right. It's make a suggestion. Yes, excellent. Great work. Great work, everyone. What about this one? Progress. What do we do with progress? What do you think goes with progress? Is it make or do? What do you think? If you're doing well, what do we say with progress? Pi is saying to make progress. What do you think? Susmita saying do progress. Okay, we've got both answers. What do you think it is? Make progress or do progress? Progress is uncountable. Yeah, progress is uncountable. Excellent point there. Ranim, make progress. I'm saying make progress. Let's have a look. The answer is to make progress, as lots of people have said, to make progress. Again, there's perhaps not an easy to say reason why we don't say do. It's just a pattern that we use. We say make progress. That's the collocation we use. Okay, another one. It could be for other things as well. Maybe before going out, something, your hair. Do you make your hair? Do you do your hair? What would we use? What do you think? Before you're going out, use the same thing as well. I don't. You could use the same thing about your nails as well. Not that I do, but someone who does could say that. What do you think goes there? What do you think? You can say to cut your hair. Well, yes, maybe you'd cut your hair. Instead of saying do, keep saying to make your hair. Mr. Truth saying to do your hair. Then he's saying to do your hair nicely. What do you think? Make or do? That's a difficult one. It's quite informal, this one, actually. But you would say, before you go out, maybe you want to do your hair. Do your hair. Okay. Let's just... So we've just looked at a few exceptions. I'll just go through them again just to remind you. We use make where you can make a call. You can make an effort. You can make a suggestion. Or you can make progress. And with do, we looked at you can do your best, you can do good, you can do harm, you can do a favor, or you can do your hair. Okay, those are other examples with make and do, apart from the pattern that we looked at earlier. Final thing I want you to try is see if you can make any sentences using these words. And I've got some examples that I can show you. Some of mine. What do you think we could do with these? Ooh, or other things. Nick has given another example here that you make an appointment. Okay, that's another good example. Thank you, Nick. That's a good one. But can you make any sentences with here? With these words. We've got soup, cleaning, a call, driving, and a favor. So I could say, for example, don't think this is true actually, but I could make amazing soup. Or I think someone said this earlier, actually. I wish I didn't have to do the cleaning. Or maybe I need to make a call. What are your... can you do similar things? Green saying, I make a call to my sister. Okay. Oh, great one. Can you do me a favor and make soup for lunch? Brilliant. I do cleaning in my house. And I was saying, lots of coming in here. I make a call because I forgot to bring my umbrella. Yes, that's a good one. Juan is saying, I do cleaning at home. Great one, Juan. Fantastic. Desi saying, I'll make soup for dinner. Wood is saying, I'm the one who always does the cleaning at home. Yes. Kim is saying, I can make an Italian soup. Oh, lovely. She made soup for her husband, an example. From Nimala. Sashiko I'm cleaning my kitchen now, says Mary. Lan, I want to make a call to my boyfriend. Mr. Trisay, is it possible to use the word produce instead of the verb make? Usually they'd be different. We wouldn't usually use them in the same way, so I wouldn't swap them over. There are some times when it will work, but not always. But it's a very good question. I see a great one there. I like to make hot potato soup. Would you do me a favor to help me do the cleaning in my home? We could say yes. Okay. Excellent. Okay. I think that's all we've got time for today. Please don't forget the worksheet that you can download. Don't forget that we'll be posting this lesson up on our Facebook and YouTube channels so you can watch it again. It's been great to see you all here. I loved your comments. I love you that you've joined in and to see how many people have been here. Thank you so much. Don't miss any of the other live lessons that will be coming up. And I'll see you next time. Take care. Bye.